Now to York County, that's where we find News 8's Ed Weinstock live in Wrightsville. Ed, what's the situation right now?
Hello, Kaylin. The North Front Street neighborhood in Wrightsville was hardest hit by the flooding. It is now starting to recover, but there is so much to do before life returns to normal. Despite calls to evacuate, Marty Engelhardt of Wrightsville and his family decided to ride out the flooding. And he has a big job now of removing the stuff that washed up on his front lawn. The North Front Street neighborhood saw close to 4 feet of water on the street. But the good news is that neighborhood homes are largely intact.
Relief? Glad? It's over? Now we got to go forward.
And what's the first thing you're going to do?
Move everything back in, and we all cleaned last night and get rid of all this debris.
A Wrightsville fire truck is now washing down the mud-covered streets of the neighborhood. As you can see behind me right now, the street is still closed, and a National Guard unit is still here providing security for the neighborhood. We don't know yet how much longer they'll be here. That's a story from Wrightsville. Back to you, Caitlin.
And Ed, there is still a reminder to conserve water there?
That's right. The issue with the mayor of Wrightsville is to ensure the recovery of the wastewater treatment plant. And that's one of the reasons that they want people in Wrightsville to continue to conserve water. But up the road is the reservoir for Wrightsville and the water treatment plant. That was not impacted by the flooding. So that's the good news. But again, conserve water in Wrightsville, and above all, stay out of the river.
Yeah. All right. Some good advice. Thank you, Ed.